Microsoft just dropped the full technical specifications for their upcoming Xbox Series X.
If you're looking for something to be happy about, Microsoft has revealed the full tech specs for the Xbox Series X. That rhymes. We don't want to bore you with every little granular detail, but we do have a full rundown on IGN.com, but it's definitely worth going over some of the key points.
That's right, let's get into some incredibly nerdy key points. The console will be powered by an 8-core custom Zen 2 CPU from AMD, which runs at a 3.8 gigahertz. The GPU, also a custom chipset from AMD based on the RDNA 2 architecture, can hit 12 teraflops. For RAM, the system is sporting 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory, and the Series X will also come with a 1 terabyte custom SSD. It will still support physical media by way of a 4K UHD Blu-ray drive, and Microsoft notes that in pure frame rate terms, the performance target is 4K at 68 frames per second and up to 120 frames per second, and it comes with 6 POGs. It's not true. I made that up. It's nonsense.
I love it. A note about the storage. Digital Foundry found that the funny port in the back of the console is indeed for expandable storage. It'll use proprietary SSDs if you run out of internal space. We have more info on that. Check out today's Daily Fix. Another thing that Digital Foundry discovered via their tests is that the Series X processor is powerful enough to run 4 Xbox One S games sessions simultaneously. So you can play 4 games at once. You physically can't, but the system can.
Maybe it's doing that at night when you're sleeping. It's playing 4 games at the same time.
It's a bigger gamer than you are.
Your power bill's gonna be crazy and it's your Xbox's fault. The system's quick resume feature can also store game states in the SSD, allowing for the system to be completely turned off and unplugged, like me, and then boot back up right where you left off. According to an Xbox blog post, another hard sentence to say, one of the testers left the system off for a week, then updated it and continued where he was in the game. Which game? We don't know, because they won't tell us, because the games aren't out yet. The system isn't out yet. This is crazy. That's why we're talking about these numbers.
I love when I'm playing a game to just turn it off entirely for an entire week and then play it again. Just take a week break. That's good. Anyway, now it's Sony's turn. It would be really nice to see something besides a logo for the PlayStation 5. With E3 canceled this year, we really don't have a sense of when Sony could show their hand, but it will happen eventually, presumably, unless it doesn't, because both consoles are still expected to launch later this year. But for all the latest next-gen news, stay right here on IGN, and we will see you on the next IGN Now that we are hosting. Because only 5 people came into the office today.
If you want to trade pogs when you get them, hit me up. I got some cool ones.
Yeah, but wash your hands.
Yeah, and
also,
pogs.
Don't go outside.
Don't go anywhere.